Night Row of Gaming.
Nintendo Time.
Super Nintendo.
Talk now, waiter.
Enjoy my channel and have fun.
Hello and welcome to my retro gaming zone. I am Tomaniac and this time I play the game Burp. Arkanoid, do it again on the Super Nintendo. And this is the first time I insert the cartridge into my machine, my Super Nintendo. And I run this through my FrameMeister, so I think, yeah, the output quality is really nice. And yeah, I'm a fan of these breakout games, and I don't know if we have a good version also here, if this is part 3. I don't know if there's a part 3, while... Because the first is Arkanoid, and the second is Arkanoid Revenge of Do, and this third, maybe, Do It Again. And so, there we have it, Do, and Lock Entry. And I hope this is controllable with the pad, and in a good way, Do It Again. Press Start button, and I have to get used to the SNES controller a little bit, because I haven't played SNES for a long time. Maybe more than a year ago I played some NES. And yeah, so I press start and give it a try, and hope we will have some fun. Push start button. One player option. So what can we choose? Player speed, slow, fast, so this is something in the middle. Player stock, 5 or 7 balls, yeah, let's take 5. Game level easy, edit, sound, stereo, background music, special edition, things, effects, exit. And now we push the start button and try this out. One player. And it has a password system, so this is nice already. Date. The 11th. Stardawn. 75.05. PT. Pulsar time. So there's an intro. Cool. Entry. Our sensors have detected a stunning new Terra-class planet.
Oho, oho.
Alas, I love breakout games. Somehow, I played them very often in my childhood, and it started with Breakout or Super Breakout on the Atari 2600, which was paddle controlled. I dispatched our scout ship, Faus, to conduct initial colonization surveys. Our joy was short-lived. Okay. So. Mr. Doe. So. Okay. And now. Let's do it. And yes. Ah, yeah. When I press the A button while I'm moving to the left or to the right, I can increase the speed of the bed. Yeah, with the A button only. The other, I can also press I have to correct myself. B button gives speed, and also the Y button. Ah, L for laser. And I can, how can I shoot? I don't know. Ah! When I use the right shoulder button, then I can choose, and I can also choose with shoot with A and with X. Okay, did this. nice graphics, I think. It looks really, really cool. I really start to like this. And yeah, I love these games because they are somehow relaxing, but yeah, they are getting more difficult with each level because yeah, the longer the ball stays in the game, the more speed it gets, and then everything will get hard. Ah, what was this M? I don't know anymore. So that was cool to get the laser. Yeah, and this is the first time I insert this cartridge, and I bought this one from the retro gaming fair at Nordweiker Haut. And it's really cool. And it was rather cheap. What was it for? 4 euro or something? And normally I don't really buy off NES cartridges because to me many of them are too expensive. And yeah, this time I had some luck, and I think the farther away from Germany you are, the cheaper the games can be. So it was a really good decision to go to Nordweiker Haut. This was my first time I got there. And yeah, perhaps not my last time. Yeah, it was organized by the Tilburg Retro Fair. And yeah, perhaps I will visit it next time, but then it will be at another location, not Nordweiker Haut. And I've met some cool guys there. The Neo Gunlock and the Wicked Gamer and Collector. Kind greetings if you watch my video. Hope you have fun with my channel and with these videos I have there, and also with this one. Yeah, this is a really, really nice version of Arkanoid. Wow. Okay, so what is this P? Don't know what P means. Poosing alive. I really like this. And there's also an Arkanoid version for the NES. And what's special about this version is that it comes with a pedal controller, especially for the NES. And yeah, I've seen this the first time in my life, something about 1.5 years ago. Someone sold it on the retro game fair at Apeldoorn, and at the time I didn't have an NES. But I saw this. Or did I have the NES already? Well, but later on, yeah, it was sold out. It was gone. And yeah, I was too late. Maybe that way. Yeah. But if I have the possibility to get one again, to see one, then I definitely am interested in buying it. Because of, yeah, it's a special device, and to control the bat with pedals is really comfortable. Wow! Now we are talking! Ah, this is the biggest size I can get. Yeah, And again, it makes lots of fun. It's a really cool. I really like these breakout games, especially Arkanoid. It's a milestone of breakout games, in my opinion. And yeah, what do you think about this game, about this version? And yeah, it's the first time after many months I play a game on the NES. And I definitely like to collect more games for that system. I also have the ST2 SNES because many of the games are so expensive and I don't want to pay that money for them. And yeah. But I like to have a good graphical output. At the moment, the FrameMaster does an awesome work and I think the output quality is really, really awesome. So, but to me, what speaks for getting an analog SNES NT is the possibility to switch between 50 and 60 hertz so that I can play NTSC games without problems. Because running an NTSC game in PAL, it's slower. Something about yeah, nearly 20%, I think, what I've read. Slower than on an NTSC machine. And when I can switch to 60 hertz, then I have no problem. This is yeah, this is the main reason why I could be interested in this analog. Oh, that was close. SNES NT. And it has an affordable price, not as the analog NT for the NES, which is something about US$400. And that's the reason why I bought myself an AVS from Retro USB for the NES games, and the result is awesome. I'm totally pleased with that, and so I don't need the analog NT. Yeah, as I said, the only reason why I'm interested in this SNES NT is to switch between 50 and 60 hertz and to play Famicom and Super Famicom games without problems. But therefore, I have to get some more of the games into my collection. Or eben to play via my SD2 SNES. So that I can also use hacks or homebrew versions if I like to, or fan translations of games you normally only get in Japanese, and of some games there are nice fan translations into English, so then it's no problem for me to understand. But there are also some games also on the NES sector which are released only in Japan, but you don't need to know Japanese to play them. Yeah, what I can say here, it's a really, really nice version of Arkanoid, and yeah, I really like this one. It's the first time I play this version, this Do It Again. Never heard of this before. Never heard of that there is another version. I thought there were only two parts and not a third one called this way. So this one seems to be tricky. You have to get. Yeah! What is that? And. Okay, so yeah, okay, this is a good idea. Yeah, you can do this more of what has happened. Okay, so this was something like a level clear. And this little teleporter eating up my ball and releasing it in at the right spot. Yeah, I like this. What more to say? Yeah, we play a little bit of this one again, and then I think it should be enough for the first time, for a first impression. Yeah, it's Arkanoid at its best, and yeah, I start to like this very much, this SNES version. Especially as I don't have many games for my SNES, and so having a nice game for the console, yeah, it's great, it's cool. Oh, what was this? So it was a good investigation into this. What comes now? What is this? What happens? Is this a level boss or something? Guess I should avoid these shots. Okay, I don't know how much, how often I have to hit this whatsoever worm. Ah, yeah, okay, so I don't know if this is a bonus level or if... No, it doesn't seem so. It's it seems to be a level boss, something like that. And I definitely have to avoid these blue shards or whatsoever. Don't know how often I have to hit this Amiga ball worm. Okay, so that was a good shot, I think. Yes, I have to get above this worm. And then... Yeah, now come. Come to me and die. Okay, so what now? Did I get him? Did I finish him? No. Okay, okay, okay. Not bad. Oh, I like it. I like it. What a cool version of Arkanoid. Never heard of that before, as I said. Yes! I made it! You! So, okay. What comes next? Oh, another background graphic. Yeah? Really cool. I really can recommend this. If you see it somewhere, if you... like breakout games, and if you like Arkanoid, and if you have an SNES at home, yeah, don't hesitate, buy this one. I got this one for cheap. I paid not more than 4 or 5 euro for this, and yeah, but what I have to say, it's not that easy to find. I came to this by chance, and the retro fair was close to an end, and the Shadow Snows and I, we talked with Neo Gunlock and the Wicked Game Collector, and they have had a stand and sold the games, and yeah, they have found this game. So yeah, cool. And yeah, it's a pleasure to get to know you. And yeah, I think so. Now we have enough for. Can I push? Yeah. Okay. So this should be enough for a first impression, a first look into Arkanoid. Do it again for the SNES. And I really, really like this one, and I really can recommend the game, and I hope you had fun watching this video, and if so, it would be really cool if you give a thumb up when you like it, and if you subscribe to my channel if you didn't have already, and I thank you for watching, and see you next time. Have a good time. Bye.